Hello, YouTube! Sorry for the short vlog, but there's really not that much going on right now, except for the fact that I still haven't gotten my internet. I guess as a reminder for those of you who don't know, I'm recording these ones in advance, like all of this Pokemon episodes, because I've been having a lot of trouble with the internet companies here in Panama. It's just they just haven't come to install it. I guess that's the problem. And I mean, I'm struggling a little bit with this whole thing because, you know, I got my YouTube channel and I'm trying to get some content there, and this is happening to me. So, a grow life. I think I got pretty much my complete setup team here. I may just save up the last spot for like a legendary or something. I'm not sure, like, what are the, which legendary I will be getting first, because this is modified and all, so, what do you mean you're closing the content? Oh, come on, because I'm the new park warden, and I said I'm closing the contest. Oh, that's not my rival, it's just a weird guy. Well, you can't do that, the contests have been going for years without problems. It's the other warden's fault for moving to the Orange Islands. He should have known this would happen. Wait, what? So the other warden moved out, now a new warden is in and he's a douchebag? Is that what's going on? I don't have time for this nonsense. What are you staring at? Jesus. We used to hold contests regularly here in the park until the warden moved out. The new warden stopped the contest. Alright, so I guess everything that I said on the last episode is not gonna happen because there is no contest. I get the other guys to poke at a sticker if I win, if I'm playing with stickers. You guys remember that? Oh my god! The Game Boy had a printer. Do you guys ever got that? Like, I never really got those peripherals. I only got that little like lamp because it was impossible to see anything when you play the Game Boy. I take walks in the park, but I never go into the grass. Trainers always battle whatever. I didn't really even pay attention to what you say. Pay attention. Wow, she knew I wasn't paying attention. I have to quit thinking like a teacher all the time. You must be a Pokemon trainer. Since you're working so hard, I want you to have this, and it's gonna give me a Quick Claw, right? Yes, Quick Claw. Quick Claw. If I can equip it to a guy, let's do that. And every time that dude attacks, he's gonna have a chance of moving first, thanks to the Quick Claw, even though he would be slower. And I'm giving it to Heracross because he have a Brave Nature, and Brave Nature's reduces speed, so he might be going to a second every now and then. That hopefully helps. My Pokemon are simply darling. Let me tell you how proud my darlings make me. Okay, so there are gonna be a couple of trainers here. Really, nothing too big, except he intimidates me. So let's go ahead and go into Awesome here, and hopefully take care of him on the special side. I always liked Snubbull and Granbull, which is the evolution. They sort of have the special. The entire like second generation of Pokemon have something like special to them. It's very weird. Like, do you guys remember how Togepi appeared in the anime, like on the first generation of the anime, even though he was a second generation Pokemon? Like, because of that, there was always something special about Togepi. Sort of like, we already knew him even before he became sort of like the second generation. So even before he became a thing, we already knew him. So it was, I guess, special in that way. Like, I always felt like that for Snubbull and Granbull. And I honestly don't think he actually appeared until the Orange Islands thing, but I don't know, for whatever reason, did he appear before? I don't know, it sort of feels like that, but I don't think so. Anyways, it just sort of felt special for me, that Pokemon, and I think many others. The second generation had some really cool ideas for Pokemon that I think were not taken for the third gen. I don't know, this after the second gen, it really does feel like the type. And I guess the ideas of what Pokemons were going to be were a little distorted and just weird. I don't even know. But anyways, we're gonna be fighting some Oddishes here. I could do Fury Cutter, but I don't think it's gonna kill it. Dragon Claw might. I don't even. Fury Cutter is gonna be super effective, or it's not because it's part poison. I forget. Haha. And let's use Dragon Claw. Yeah. Yes, it's gonna kill him. Well, I mean, it hits about as strong as a brick except that it's not very effective. So let's use Mr. EG here. Can't wait for him to get Shadow Ball because I'm so tired of Nightshade. Well, Nightshade is strong and all. It's just, you know, Shadow Ball is gonna be stronger. Oh, Beedrill. Beedrill was always a cool Pokemon. It just never really got the attention because of his stats. I mean, and I'm not just talking competitively, like the battling with Pokemon level 100, but just in general, like Beedrill never really had those stats. But it was always such a cool Pokemon with the freaking like stings, huge ass like meter long stings. He had a lot of potential. But anyways, he's gonna die. I don't think I have an antidote, do I? Let's see. Antidote. Yeah, I do have 7. Sweet. So, the contest, you would, like, go through the grass here, and you would find Pokemon, and then you would catch them, and then you would be judged by how rare or how cool the Pokemon was. Oh, there's a Pokeball. Let's see if we can get that. Yes, we can. All right. Let's get that. Paralyzing heals. That's pretty cool. Nothing about here. Let's see. Whoa, this is a special place here. Dig. We got ourselves some dig. Let's see if, okay, Awesome can learn it. I'm not really too into that. I mean, actually, that would be cool for him to learn because then he would actually be able to take on electric Pokemons. And I guess that's cool and all. What moves does he have though? Maybe that's actually a good idea. He has Rock Tomb. No, I'll leave it like that. I don't really. It would be Dig would be better than Rock Tomb, but I already taught him Rock Tomb, and I don't want to like take it off. I don't even know. Some Pokemon can only be seen in the park. Yeah, I guess Scyther. I remember Scyther could be, and maybe Pinsir. I don't remember anymore. But I guess we're not getting a Sunstone or an Everstone from there anymore. I'm going to read your thoughts. All right, he's the Kadabra guy. I remember this guy. Oh, the Pokemon changed now. But it's so cool that it's raining because I can use like rain boosted Water Gun. So that's cool. But if it's gonna be using screens, then I'm not gonna be able to do any damage to him like whatsoever. Ice Punch is probably going to be stronger at this point because of Awesome has like more physical attack. But now that he has his screens on, and he actually has Magical Leave. It might be a better idea to go into Ghastly and just Nightshade, because his screens obviously doesn't work with an attack that always does the same amount of damage, so that's pretty cool. But I should stay away from his other psychic Pokemon because a psychic or a confusion will kill me. So a Kadabra, Awesome should be able to take care of that. I still remember when I was a kid, I used to like play with my cousin, like pretending we were Pokemon, and I mean, it was obviously really childish and all, but we would, like, I remember I would, like, roleplay that I was Kadabra, and I would, like, take, like, spoons from my house and just go to the park and just, like, I don't know, man, just fucking go, like, Kadabra, just wave my spoon, just running around, and then people would look at me and judge me and tell me how weird I was because I was running about with a spoon yelling Kadabra. But those were good times, man. Those were really good times. Oh, Tangela is physically bulky, so it's not gonna take that much damage. Oh, that almost did me right there. So I'm gonna go ahead oh gosh, let's take Brandon and train much. He should resist the Bind Whip, I think. I never remember what are the resistances of Dragon type. They have so many resistances. It's so weird. But Ember. Gosh, so resistant. Tangela is such a bulky son of a bitch. Seriously. And he always remembered me of that. What was it? Was it McDonald's? Or was it Burger King? It was like one of those. Fuck, I think it was Burger King. Just little mascot of it. It's just whatever. You guys know what I'm talking about. And if not, then I'll just have a little picture there. But he's gonna kill someone of my Pokemon. And I don't think there's really anything you can do about that. Let's go and throw in Claws. And, fuck, I don't think it's gonna kill him, but, like, oh, the power, man. The raw power of Claws. All right, that's cool. Darn, I study 5 hours a day, too. Man, that's crazy. I never studied. Guess what I want to say. Let's go to Alexandria. We haven't used her. in this episode, and let's go to talk to this little girl. I'm the flower shop Floria. Listen, listen. When I sprinkled water on that wiggly tree, it jumped right up. It just has to be a Pokemon. I bet it would be shocked out of his disguise if you soaked it. I know. I'll tell my sis and borrow her water bottle. Dude, it's raining. Okay? It's raining. It's always raining in this game. How can... Would it even matter if I grab a freaking bottle of water? Like, man, it's so weird. Like, I'm saying it as a joke. Like, oh, it's always raining, but it's really always raining. I mean, it's really good for my Pokemon, except for my Ember on my Dagon. But Bacon, Dagon, Bacon. I should have called him Bacon. It's always raining, and it's good for me because I guess Croconaw is gonna be a beast, but. This is weird. I think it's here. Yes. La 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 la. Plenty of water, my lovely, so did the girl. When I told my sis about the jiggly tree, she told me it's dangerous. If I meet Whitney, I wonder if she'll lend me her water bottle. I should leave, come back, and that should be fine, right? When I told my sis about the jiggly tree, she told me if I Whitney, I wonder if she'll... Come on! Oh, did I never got it? Wait. I don't know if I ever got it. Well, this thing is bugged. Like, I realized the other episode, it's supposed to be the third batch that I have, not the fourth one, obviously. So that's a little weird. But, I'm pretty sure I got the batch. I mean, I know that she cries and then you have to talk to her again. I'm sure I did that. That was a good cry. Come for a visit again. Bye-bye. I'm trying to be Whitney, but it's depressing. I'm okay. If I lose, I'll just try harder next time. Give me the batch! Dude, I don't know what's wrong. I should be able to... Look, that's just weird. Straight up. Is this game bugged? Like, I'm not gonna be able to pass by now? Holy crap, if that's so. Okay, there you are. I had to talk to the sister again. Oh, you're better than Whitney. You'll be okay. Then here's the squirt bottle. And it's gonna give me the squirt bottle. Okay, that's pretty chill. We got the bottle that squirts. Because... I have no joke. let's go ahead and continue with our little quest here and destroy this little guy. Let's use Alexandria should be fine. Funny story. Up until this point, like, I always thought that rock type Pokemon were actually resistant to electric type moves, and it's obviously because every rock type Pokemon in the first gen was also part ground, except Aerodactyl. Like, that was the only Pokemon that actually was not ground, but was also rock. And every time you would use an electric Pokemon in the first gen, it would ground type, the ground type would block it. I just wanted to thank you for clearing this path. Please accept this gift as my thanks. And whatever, I don't want to plant berries. Jesus Christ. So it's like I always thought that rock was also resistant to it. And like, I guess I can't even talk with this game. So many stuff happening. Where's your leader? As I said, where is your leader? Okay, so I don't know who those guys are. I don't know. Please don't hurt us. Grunt 2, forget this guy. We need to do our mission. That professor lives in Newark Town, right? Yeah, we better get going. Hey, come back. Damn it, they got away. I let them slip through my fingers again. Hey, it's you again, Rex, right? Well, I need to go to Newark Town. Maybe their leader is there. What? That's your hometown? Then you better get down there. Where would you go on ahead? I'll meet you there. So he's not gonna let me pass? Well, I mean, luckily we have a shortcut here. But before that, I want to express what I want to say. And I guess let's do that. So the way that I rationalized it was that because Aerodactyl was part flying, that it sort of broke the whole rock type, like, blocking electric attacks. So that's how I rationalized me being able to hit Aerodactyl. But then I couldn't hit any other right type Pokemon. So I thought, hey, rock type, electric must be non-effective against rock. Except that when I got to Sudowoodo, he was only part rock, and he could be dealt electric attacks. And then all throughout, like, my life, like, up until, like, literally, like, last year, I thought that Sudowoodo was, like, a special being, like, a special creature, that he was the only rock-type Pokemon that could actually be hurt from electric attacks. And I thought that up until like last year, it was such a like, it was one of those things where you go like, whoa, my entire life was a lie. You know, like I always thought rock was resistant to it. So what am I supposed to do, to go to the professor here? Hey, you're that guy I saw on Route 36. I didn't read what he said. He's after us for some reason. You're stealing our way. I'm gonna have to eliminate you. All right, so who are these guys? Saturn? Those sprites are just hilarious. It's like a weird, like, ginger dude. Oh, that's hilarious. I just find it hilarious just having, like, that huge red beard. It's just, I think it's just funny. Maybe it's, I'm sorry if I offended anyone. I'm sorry. But yeah, this is gonna be pretty easy because ground is quite effective against Magnemites, which is their main weakness, I guess. Man, if Magnemites got levitate, which they should in lore terms, but they shouldn't in like freaking balance terms. But they're obviously floating, so if they got levitate, like any other floating Pokemon, they would be freaking invincible. Like, seriously, they would have so many resistances, so many immunities. It just would be beautiful. You're not getting away with this. I just did. We are Team Saturn. Our only goal is to capture all legendary Pokemon. Why? So we can rule the world, of course. What other bad freaking team? Jesus Christ, everyone was the same thing. Nobody will stand in our way. We gotta rule the world. And then these other guys. A different type of ginger, but this is a cool one. This is a mustache ginger. Alexandria, go! You can't poison me! I'm invincible! Man, I really need to get some earthquakes going on here. I don't have any more. Oh. Yes, not gonna be. Alexandria is so defensive. So awesome. Yeah. And, oh god. Man. I don't know. Where do you get moonstones in here? Because I'm pretty sure that. Because you need moonstones for a lot of Pokemon in this game, for the same ones in the first gen, Nidorino, Nidorina, Clefairy, whatever, but you also need it for the ones that used to evolve from trade. Headbutt is 70, takedown is 90, but has a chance of missing, so fuck that. I don't really like this one. Bulbpix, we're gonna go ahead and use Mr. AG, because Claws is weak to it. We're gonna need a moonstone to actually, I think it's to evolve Haunter now in this game, so we need to find one, and I don't know where to find one. Ductrio, nice catch, bro. That sounds pretty cool because it's pretty early on in the game. Already has a Ductrio, that's nice. Yeah, another Wardigon should be able to take care of business here, and Team Saturn, whatever they think they are
done.
Oh, that was great. Oh, Alexandria is evolving! This is the happiest day of my life! Yeah! Man, he looks badass! Holy crap! Alright, that's good. He's entering on Fury Attack. Seriously? I don't want to learn Fury Attack. Ah! I can't believe I was beaten by some meddling kid under Pikachu! It looks like you were in the wrong place at the wrong time. You messed it up for us today, kid. You wait until next time.
Thank you so much, Rex!
That's how he talks? You saved me from. I can't do that like very nerdy boys. I tried it. And that's what came out. You saved my life from those terrible people. I don't even know what I'm sounding like. They call themselves Team Saturn. They look like a bunch of loonies to me. They were after some rare Pokemon, two to be exact. I think it's Latias and Latios, but they're not living in Johto. Oh no. And then Axel, you shouldn't have run off like. What? You told me to. What the fuck is wrong with these people? He told me to come here. I got lost trying to find this place. Are you okay, Professor? I'm fine, thanks. Not thanks to you. Rex here got here just in time to scare those people off. Who are you, though? What? Rex, how could you let them go? You knew I was after them. Oh, well. I'm Axel from the Oko. The fuck? That I don't think we have ever... I don't think there's a game from this region yet, so that's cool, I guess. I came to Johto to study new kinds of Pokemon. I'm very impressed. I was looking around for Pokemon when I ran into Rex. Aha, Oka. I've heard a lot about the Pokemon there. The Pokemon we have in Johto are very different from the Pokemon in Oka. Yes, I've noticed. Well, I better get going. I'll catch you two later. So I wanna see those weird Pokemon. He seems like a nice guy. Thanks again for helping me out, Rex. Good luck with your Pokedex quest. Oka. Okay. Actually, I don't know if we have made a game. If they had made a game of Oka, I don't want to say it's not, but I don't recognize it. Rex, you look. Wow, that's the nicest thing someone has ever said to me. Like, I'm here killing Pokemon, fighting them, you know, making them bleed and killing them. And he finds time somehow, with all his research, to tell me that I look great. It's really something beautiful.